This episode is sponsored by Ren, a website with a monthly subscription that helps fund projects to combat the climate crisis. Click the link in the description to learn more about how you can make a monthly contribution to support projects like rainforest protection programs. If you've spent any time in Florida and the USA, you may have been lucky enough to encounter one of their most famous locals. And it's not the Florida man. It's the Florida Manatee. These slow-moving sea cows face a number of human-caused threats, from boat collisions to habitat loss. One of the most surprising threats is also caused by humans: the closing of aging power plants. The good news is, since we created this situation in the first place, we should be able to find a way out of it. The Florida manatee is the most northerly subspecies of West Indian manatee. It's found almost exclusively in the southeastern United States, though commonly called sea cows, they're more closely related to elephants. You'll find these amazing marine mammals hanging out in shallow coastal waters, from seagrass meadows to salt marshes. And they've adapted to some pretty warm temperatures. That might be surprising to hear, given that they look pretty insulated, but that's not actually the case. Combine that with their low metabolic rates, and they're just not great at keeping themselves warm. These gentle giants can actually die if the water stays below 18 to 20 degrees Celsius for long stretches. When temperatures reach as low as 10 to 12 degrees, they can succumb to the cold in only a few days. And we might think of Florida as pretty balmy, but even the southernmost tip can hit these temperatures during cold winters. Although they don't come off as the most athletic of species, manatees can actually cover significant distances during seasonal migrations. Some individuals travel as far as 830 kilometers between their summer and winter hangouts. However, instead of taking on longer migrations, some populations of manatees seek out refuge in warm water to survive cold spells. That is, pockets of warm water in an otherwise cooler area. These could be naturally occurring springs or passive thermal basins, which are heated by the sun, groundwater, or other natural phenomena. Or they can be the discharged water from power plant cooling systems. And these unintentional man-made refuges are really popular with manatees. A 2004 report found that of the 14 warm water refuges in northern and central Florida, 10 were outfalls from power plants. These power plants attract around 60% of all of Florida's manatees. The worrying thing is, all of these manatee-attracting power plants are decades old and are either close to retirement or have shut down already. And these days, restrictions on thermal pollution prohibit new power plants from discharging notably warmer waters. This means once these old plants are out of commission, most of the warm water refuges the manatees currently depend on will be too. What's most distressing is that while other populations take on longer winter migrations to find safety from the cold, the manatees who have come to depend on a particular power plant don't seem to shift their habits. Calves learn from their moms what refuges to use and typically stick with the same site their whole lives. And if past power plant retirements are anything to go by, the manatees will keep coming back after the warm water is gone, even if it means succumbing to the cold. On top of that, the natural springs that manatees depend on may also be disappearing thanks to climate change and human overuse. But there are ways we can help wean manatees off of power plants. One possible way is by literally erecting sea cow fencing. By shifting these barriers further away from the plant over time, the manatees might be encouraged to find new naturally warmed water refuges elsewhere. Protecting the waters they currently use is also key to ensure there aren't further losses of natural warm winter hangouts beyond the power plants. Another solution could be to make other warm water areas more accessible through better management of natural springs and removing barriers that may impede larger numbers of manatees from using them. There's even talk of making new human-made warm water refuges that aren't tied to another industry, so there isn't the same risk of them aging out of service. There's still a lot of work that needs to be done to determine which of these options are the most beneficial to the manatees and ensure they don't harm any other species in the meantime. The good news is, with multiple options to explore, there's hope for protecting these much-loved sea cows from meeting a frigid demise. Thank you for watching this episode of SciShow, and thank you to today's sponsor, Ren. Ren is a website with a monthly subscription that helps fund projects to combat the climate crisis. Ren searches the globe for projects that have the biggest potential, like protecting rainforests and planting trees. And these projects wouldn't be possible without your support. Over the long term, we need governments to fund these projects, but we can start by crowdfunding them. And we've partnered with Ren to protect an extra 10 acres of rainforest for the first 100 people who sign up using our link in the description. You can also check out more about their approach and what projects they are currently funding. Thanks again for watching.